All right, let's look this morning at how to reverse a string in T-SQL, which is actually pretty easy since SQL Server 2008, which is just you use the reverse function on the string. And note that I could directly pass in the string, a string literal. I don't have to variableize it, but if I want to use a variable, I can. That's the same thing with a column. You could pass in a column if you're selecting from a table. So as you see, of course, with HANA, it's not a very helpful example because it is a palindrome, and when you reverse it, you get the same thing. John, as you can see, it is reversed. Now, if you're in SQL Server 2005, I believe you can, I think there's len and I believe there's substring, and between those two, you know, you can probably reverse a string. I can try to do it on the fly. Of course, one thing about coding is you never code live, but I'm going to violate that rule and see if I can do this. The difference here is I'm going to switch string 1 to John, and then I'm going to empty string 2. And the reason is because if you reverse HANA, you get HANA, so you couldn't really prove your point or prove that you did it right if you actually are dealing with a palindrome. So length I'm going to declare as int, and the reason is because at least on the fly I'm going to loop through each character in the string. So I'm going to set length equal to the len of my string 1. And I believe that len is available in 2005. I'm pretty sure it is. I haven't worked in 2005 in a while. And the reason is because if environments are using that, okay, and then each pass I'm going to subtract from the length. And then I'm going to start at the end. But the reason why I don't use 2005 is because the support is gone. So if you're in a 2005 environment, definitely be encouraging them to upgrade, because if they don't, it's greater than zero, that could end up in trouble. So while the length is greater than zero, so each pass on the length, because we want to go one character at a time all the way down, we're going to go ahead in each loop, we're going to set length equal to length minus one, so we're going to subtract from it, and then we're going to add to my string 2, and at the end I'm going to select my string 2. All right, and then we're going to substring, and I believe this is also available in SQL Server 2005, and we are going to substring the length, and remember it's deprecating each loop, and we're going to be doing one. So each time it rolls around on the loop, it should be subtracting. So it's going to start at first at 4, because there's 4 characters, and 4 and 1 is 0, of course, and then the next one is 3 and 1, and so on and so forth. Whoops. And it says you must declare variable length. Fine. Come on. You can do that, but I must have the wrong name somewhere. Length is a weird word. And there we go. John, it must be less like, is it Latin? It just looks strange. All right. And then we go John. So we can actually type in a longer string. Let's say dogs are man's best friend, and so is Bitcoin. Of course, in this case, we probably should expand our varchars to 250. I'm not exactly sure how many characters that is, but it's a lot longer. And there you go. Kind of looks like medicine. Neocates. Anyway, so that's one way to do that. And if I had enough time, I could probably figure out some other techniques to reversing a string, at least in 2005. But I'm pretty sure that len and substring are available, and provided that those two are available, you should be able to do it through the loop. So basically, I violated one of the rules, which is never ever code live, because you never know what could come up. But it definitely works, and like I said, I would definitely think about some other ways to approach that problem, only because that might not be the most optimal way in 2005. However, if you're in a 2005 environment, you have bigger fish to fry as far as getting out of a 2005 environment.